Thank you all for returning this evening and supporting our children in their endeavor. First, I would just like to say that I want to thank Sister Monica, who is the director, also Courtney and Chris Woods Jr., along with Sister Juanita, as well as Sister Margot, Sister Diane, and Sister Stephanie, who labored very hard to put this together. So let's give them a round of applause. And also all the children who also sacrificed their time to participate in this, we thank you. As we go through this program this evening, I would just like everybody to keep in mind that although we are celebrating the arrival of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, keep in mind that it didn't end with his arrival. And also keep in mind that when he came with a mission. And the mission was to save us from our sins by going to the cross and sacrificing his life to save us from our sins. So as we do celebrate this Advent season, I would just like everybody to keep that in mind, that it doesn't end with the manger. Didn't even end with the cross or the resurrection, because we are still looking forward to his return. Amen?
Amen.
Right, with that, I'd like to open up with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, as we come before you today, Lord, thank you once again for allowing us to see another Christmas. Lord, we pray that as we celebrate the birth of your Son, Jesus Christ, and our Lord and Savior, that this will bring honor and glory to you. Lord, we thank you for sending your Son. We thank you, Jesus, for coming and dying on the cross at Calvary to save us from our sins. Lord, we pray that all of this is just pleasing in your sight. Lord, and once again, we just want to say thank you for giving us this time and this opportunity to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. In your name, Jesus, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
All right, so first up, we will have Sister Carol. She will have a selection. She will be playing Lamb of God. And I also want to say thank you, Sister Carol, for filling in at the last meeting. We appreciate it.
Thank you.
from the flock of sheep that were used for sacrifices at the temple of Jerusalem.
How absurd is that? Jesus was our sacrifice.
I can see how the Christmas people all come together. We can see a bright light, and the shepherds will fall down on their knees and shield their eyes.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people today in the town of David. A Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger.
On earth, peace to men. On earth,
Israelites getting ready to leave Egypt. Each family was preparing.
I don't know if I want to go back too much into the history of Passover, but I do have to show the significance of Jesus being born on Sabbath, the Passover lamb.
Somewhere you can have one of your characters say something about the people taking the blood from the lamb and putting it on the doorpost so that the Lord would pass over and, you know, without claiming the life of the firstborn.
I'm just bogged down when I get to the ending. How can I get back to the Christmas story? I mean, I have some of that left.
And it came to pass in those days, Nero had a decree from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed. And all went to be taxed. Everyone into his own city.
He got onto his own, and his own received him.
And Joseph also went from Galilee.
But when Pilate heard of Galilee, he asked where the man was Galilean. And as soon as he knew that he belonged to Herod's jurisdiction, he sent him to Herod.
Out of the city of Nazareth.
Can Mary the good thing come out of Nazareth?
Unto Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem. Behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he that is born, King of the Jews?
If thou be the King of the Jews, save thyself.
For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him.
And all of his acquaintances stood afar off, beholding these things.
And there were in the same country shepherds, abiding in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone round about them.
From the sixth hour there was darkness all over the land until the ninth hour.
And they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not. For I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people.
For he shall be delivered unto the Gentiles.
For unto you is born this day,
and shall be mocked
in the city of David,
and spitefully entreated,
a Savior,
and spitted,
which is Christ the Lord.
Father, into thy hands I commend my spirit.
And so it was, that while they were there, the days were accomplished that she should be delivered.
And having said this, he gave up the ghost.
And she brought forth her firstborn son.
When Joseph had taken the body
and wrapped him in swaddling clothes,
he wrapped it in a clean new linen cloth
and laid him in a manger.
And laid it in his own new tomb.
Because there was no room for them in the inn.
Where never man before was laid.
And when they were come into the house,
upon the first day of the week,
they saw the young child with Mary his mother.
They came unto the sepulchre,
and they presented unto him gifts,
bringing the spices which they had prepared,
gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
They found the stone rolled away. Behold, two men stood by them in shining garments.
And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts.
They said, Why seek ye the living among the dead?
Glory to God in the highest.
He is not here.
And on earth, peace, goodwill toward men.
He is risen.
But Mary kept all these things and pondered them in her heart.
Thank you. be orderly. Amen.
That's just like your pastor. That was fantastic. Amen.
I was as I listened to Mariah and TJ sort of compare and contrast Christ's birth with his death. Guys sort of gave me a series of sermons. And I think I came to 10 things contrasting how unusual and unique Christ's birth is compared with other things. He was born in a manger, yet buried in a borrowed tomb. He was born owner of all the earth, for the earth is the Lord's and all it contains. Yet he became poor that we might be rich. He was born, yet he had no beginning. He died, yet he is from everlasting to everlasting. He was born of a woman whom he made. He was born sinless, yet he was born to bear the sin of the world. He was born possessing a kingdom not of this world, but he was ruler over all things. He was born as a son, but he was as old as his father.
Amen.
He was born the begotten of God, yet his father praised him as Lord. He was the only man born to give life through his death. Jotted all that down while you guys were doing what you do. I know how my mind works. Now I'm going to go home and fight some more things. Amen. Somewhere down the line, that's a sermon, amen. A serious sermon.
Amen.
So thank you, Sister Mariah and TJ. You helped your pastor out this morning, amen. This afternoon, you help fill in this preaching agenda for the next year. But it's just fantastic when you think about that. It just really shows you the uniqueness of Christ. John 3:16, for God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten son, the word only begotten, the Greek monogenes. It really means unique, one of a kind, the only one of his race. And we can really see that as we look in scripture and study his person, things that are just quite profound. Amen? He was born, had a beginning, yet he had none. Amen? He died, but yet he from everlasting to everlasting. The scripture says, thou art God. You know, as you really begin to study the person of Christ, the longer I am saved, the more I am convinced that he was exactly who he claimed to be.
Yes.
He was the Messiah of Israel, the Savior of the Gentiles. God from God, light from light, eternally begotten and not made. One essence, one substance, one power, one might, one presence with his Father. Whatever the Father can do, he said he could do. He told the disciples, trust in God, trust also in me. You take my life down, I'll pick it back up again. Destroy this temple in 3 days, I'll raise it up again. Just wonderful and profound. And I really remember one year we had a Christmas program, and I remember there was a reading that Chris Woods Jr. did. That's the same one. I don't know, and I've never forgotten. There was one phrase he said in there that we can't, there's no one really we can compare with him. And so, you know, we celebrate the birth of a Savior unlike any other. Everything that I said about Jesus tonight can be said of no one else. It cannot be said of Muhammad, it cannot be said of Buddha, it cannot be said of Hare Krishna, it cannot be said of anyone but this man name Jesus. Amen? And by him being all of that, I mean, just looking at who he is, you know that somebody like this is the only one that can save you from your sins. And he's the only one that can really give you eternal life. He's the only one that can give you real life. He's the only one that can give real meaning to your life.
Yes.
And the more I look at him and just study him, the more I am convinced that he truly was the Son of God.
Amen.
Born that babe to save his people from their sins. I'm glad about it. Amen?
Amen.
And so that was just fantastic. 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 Doesn't take long to get what needs to be done. The children were very clear and very precise and, you know, doing what they need to do. It's really funny because I remember when Maya and Brianna were doing it, amen, and they were all, you know, giggling and then now they're over here. So it's killing you getting old. Just amazing to watch the circle of life.
Yes.
And it's just, and we're really blessed to see a circle of life,
yes,
in this church.
Yes.
And just remembering this, like this, and this, and now it's just, wow. And given enough time, these kids, you know, I'll be coming here with my walker and I'll be saying the same thing. And hopefully they'll be helping me out, amen? But, Just a wonderful time of the year. Just good to consider these things. You know, I mentioned all these things about the Lord. He's unique and there's no one else like him. Let us all make sure that we know him. Amen?
Amen.
Let us all make sure and be convinced that we know him. Paul admonished the Corinthians, examine yourselves to see whether you be in the faith. And from time to time, I stop and ask myself, Dave Kinlow, are you really saved?
Yes.
And I do that to take stock of why I believe, yes, I am saved. And I conclude it's not because of me, because I know me. And me, like a box of chocolates, you never know what you're going to get. Amen? Some of you guys who see me at home, you would probably say, I know he cannot be a pastor. So probably Maya could tell you some things. Don't tell it. Amen? But I ask myself that, and you ask yourself that and make sure you come up with the right answer. I know that I know him because I repented of my sins. And I really believe that this man was not just a man, but the God-man. He truly was the Son of God.
Yes.
He died on the cross of my sins. He was buried. And I was thinking this the other night. When we talk about he rose from the dead, it's amazing because he really, 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 really did.
Yes, he did.
It's not a fantasy. It's not a myth. My goodness. He really did rise from the dead.
Yes.
And I believed that for a long time. But as I say, the longer I'm saved, the more I'm convinced that he really did defeat death, hell, and the grave through his resurrection from the dead. So examine yourselves. Make sure you are really in the faith. And wow, when we begin to really look at all who Jesus is, you got a message to somebody, amen?
Amen.
I mean, all that Jesus is and you ain't got nothing to say about it? All that he is and you don't have a good word for somebody? You know about the, you know, the real reason for the season? I'll lay some of this stuff on it. Amen. He was born to die. The only son born the same age as his father, from everlasting to everlasting, thou art God. The only man born who created is mine.
Amen.
You got a lot to say. Amen.
Amen.
And so this just great stuff. Boy, you can tell I'm a preacher, can't you?
Yes.
I was born to preach, you can tell, can't you? Maybe not. But I can get a sermon out of a pumpkin. And so we thank God for that. I really, really appreciate Sister Monica stepping up to coordinate this and be over this. Last night she tried to get me, she said, I said, I'm singing with the choir. So I thought I was singing tonight. But they drafted me to sing next Sunday, so I thought I was singing tonight. And so she was over at the house yesterday, and I said, yeah, the choir drafted me. Said, well, are you going to be at rehearsal? Everybody who's on the program, you have to be at rehearsal. And I got kind of shaky, amen. I almost scared to tell her, no, I won't be there. But she gave me an excuse. She said, well, that's the prerogative of the pastor. If you don't want to come, you don't have to come. But! I really appreciate her, and I really appreciate the whole family, Sister Monica, Brother Chris, and Brother Chris Jr. And decent people, and Sister Kendall and I, amen. And we seem to kind of like a glove. So I thank God for them and their relationship and how she stepped up tonight. And I just want to say thank you, Sister Monica. Amen. And my wife and Mike get on me every year for doing this. So it's become a tradition. Amen. And that is, I want to give you a token. Amen. Of our appreciation. For you this evening. I think my wife used to complain because I would just hand it to somebody. Didn't you used to complain about that? She looking at me saying, yeah, that's
what I'm saying.
There goes up to my wife. And then it's true faith in Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior, died for you, buried, bodily rose from the dead, and there is salvation in no other but Him. Cling to Him in real saving faith. And so that is redemption. And if you don't know the Lord, and if you can just repent and believe, the Bible says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord, they shall be saved. Lord, we thank you for all who participated in this program. We thank you for all of those who came. Lord, bless us in the things of God. Bless us spiritually. Lord, provide every need that needs to be met. Lord, keep us safe. Sure, return again. We praise you and thank you. In Jesus Christ's name, may God's people say amen.
Amen. Amen.